What's good, Taurus? So we are doing your reading in regards to what you can expect this week, and we're going to do a bonus spread in regards to what you can expect this week in regards to love. Timestamp for that will be in the description box, okay? All right, keep in mind these readings are for Sun, Moon, and Rising. They are general. So take what resonates, chuck what doesn't. Roles could definitely be reversed as well. All right, what do we have for Taurus? What can Taurus expect this week? What can Taurus expect this week? Three shuffles. Overall energy for you this week, Taurus, Eight of Swords in reverse and the Knight of Wands, Ace of Wands in reverse. You're definitely putting a stop to something very quickly, in fact. Look, some of you maybe, I would be careful of making really quick judgment calls, okay? It's like you may feel the need to escape from something or avoid something or stand up to someone even. But I would, like I said, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. Okay. There could be some type of financial insecurity, but you may feel supported in that way. Okay. Because you are putting a stop, making a final judgment on someone that you feel just does not have good intentions. I don't know. Let's see. Let's pull some more. Queen of Swords in reverse. Nine of Pentacles. Tower in reverse. I feel like you're put in a situation this week, Taurus, where you may feel like you're being blamed for something. And I feel like you're avoiding letting someone blame you for their irrational thinking. And I feel like you're just separating yourself from the situation and focusing on your money, your stability, your, you know, being single potentially. Honestly, Taurus, if this is something that maybe was a false start in something or whatnot, you know, if it's a work situation, Taurus, I feel like there could have been a false start and you're just kind of dodging it before it even gets too deep. Because you may be avoiding being embarrassed or, you know, frustrated or whatever it may be. But if this is like a person that you're dealing with, I feel like you're just not letting someone put their shit on you, okay? Or you're avoiding being blamed for something. And you're definitely focused on being single, or you're focused on your own financial success at the moment. Focused on the finer things, you know, taking care of yourself, going to the spa, going shopping. Or you're just kind of enjoying yourself and you feel like someone's just lashing out at you. You know, or you feel like it's like you're not letting someone blame you for their irrational thinking. Yours is quite point blank. If anything, you feel like you've dodged a bullet a little bit here. What's this Queen of Swords in reverse? The Sun. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Someone may be expressing their insecurities and they may be justifying that in regards to their lack of change in a situation or a lack of change. Okay. I feel like a lot of you guys as well are feeling like you're getting clear in a certain financial situation or a job in regards to nothing is changing and it's not really bringing you, you may feel like a job or a side hustle that you had going on is just not worth the time and you're separating yourself from it. But if this is a person, I feel like someone here is expressing, you know, their insecurities in regards to the situation and why they may feel like they have a lack of opportunity to change, or they may be justifying not giving you something sustainable or attainable because of something they're having a hard time ending, or there's something like that. Like someone is putting the blame on either a lack of opportunity or their own personal insecurities, maybe financial insecurities, on why something has not changed. Or why the two of you, or why you're in this conversation or situation to begin with. Again, I feel like you're more so separating yourself from it in a very confident way. Like, you're not confused at all. Okay, you definitely see the situation clearly. And I feel like you're in a space of like, I'm not dealing with this. You know what I mean? You're not willing to sacrifice something here in order to make things work. You're definitely putting your boundaries up when it comes. It could be a love offer, okay, or someone that has all this love for you, but maybe they're still dealing with a lot of unfinished business from their end. And it's like, well, I have to be in this relationship because of this, that, and the third. It's like, well, bitch, get your shit together and then come at me correct, okay? Or whatever it is. Because you're thinking very negatively on the situation just because you feel like you have to defend yourself, you know, or defend your boundaries, defend why you're suspicious when you feel like it would be common sense. There's something here that you feel like you have to defend yourself to that you feel like is common sense of like, of course I'm not going to do that. Or if it's a job, it's like, of course I'm not going to work for free because this, that, and the third. Or of course I'm not, you know, there's something here, of course. Okay. Nine of Pentacles, tell me about that. Nice, with the Strength card. I'm telling you, you are super confident about, you know, a lot of you guys are detaching from something in the past here, okay? Or you're just kind of seeing someone's true character, and it may cause you to look negatively on them, let's just put it that way. You may feel like the rose-tinted glasses are off when it comes to someone's character, and you're in a space of like, boo, I don't vibe like that. I don't even entertain that, okay? It's that type of energy. It's like you're choosing to hold back. You're choosing to separate yourself from a situation with class. And it's like, boo, I don't vibe like that at all. And you're very confident about, you know, you're very confident about it. It's like you don't even really want to hear their emotional standpoint or whatnot because you're just looking at the facts. And you feel like you either can't trust this person at this point, or you feel like they just put a lot of irrational thoughts on you and you feel like they cause their own damage, but yet they put it on you. Like you need to deal with it too and bring you, you may feel like they're trying to bring you in their shitstorm. And it's like, you look again with the boundaries. You're very guarded. You're avoiding the drama. Okay. You're avoiding the drama. I like this. Just give me Eight of Swords in reverse. Just give me one more on that. Four of Pentacles in reverse. Nine of Cups in reverse. You may feel like someone justifies their selfish behavior because they are so generous or they are so giving or because they, you know, took a risk even or something like that. And I feel like you are in a space where you feel like you're seeing the situation very clearly and you're ready to let it go. You're completely over it, in fact, Taurus. Okay, and again, for those of you where this is more of an individual thing, you may feel like you made an investment here and it didn't work out in your favor. There was a wish possibly unfulfilled. And I feel like you're quickly, you know, reasserting control by focusing on what is bringing you some sense of security. And you may be trying to hold back from an old dream, an old hope, a childhood dream even, because you feel like you're gaining some type of clarity on something just not being financially stable or not being worth your time. Okay. Like some of you may feel like you've made a bad investment financially that didn't work out, or you feel like you're dealing with someone that did that. And I feel like you're in a space of like ready to, what's that? It's like you're ready to, it's like you don't want to be stupid. You're ready to back up before things get worse, whether it's a person or an investment. All right, you could be dealing with an Aries. We have Scorpio, Leo, strong Leo energy, and strong Scorpio energy. So there could be secrets a little bit, or you're seeing the true depths of a love situation here with this strong Leo and Scorpio energy, but in a way where it's kind of causing you to see someone from a different perspective or look negatively on the situation. All right, Let's get some bonus messages for you in regards to love. Ooh, we do have the Ace of Cups. What can Taurus expect in regards to love this week? What's coming through for Taurus? Three more in regards to love. One more. What's coming through for Taurus in regards to love this week? Hierophant in reverse. Five of Swords. Two of Wands, the Sun. Eight of Cups, Two of Pentacles in reverse. Well, Taurus, when it comes to love, I do feel like you're remaining optimistic. There does seem to be someone from your past, potentially, that you just have some type of conflict with, or you never seem to be able to see eye to eye. You may feel like this person is a little bit of a people pleaser, and that's irritating you. Or you feel like this person is avoiding making some type of decision. Because you're in a space of refusing to give in or refusing to conform to a past person because of some type of decision that's needed. That causes you to feel like you can't trust them, or causes you to really, you know, feel like the opportunity isn't even that great, if I'm going to be honest with you. Like someone, like you may be starting to get over someone just with their inability to take action or get their priorities right, if I'm going to be honest with you. Okay, I do see a new opportunity opening up for you. But I do still see you mentally. Like, even if you don't want this past person, there's still a lot of negative focus on it, to the point that, you know, it may be creating, you know, you to get out of alignment, okay? Let's just put it that way. Or creating you to focus on things that are not really attracting the love that you want. Tell me about this Two of Wands. Page of Cups in reverse. Three of Swords. Queen of Swords, Eight of Swords in reverse, and the Justice card. Well, Taurus, there's a lot of immaturity that's coming in here. This is like someone that feels hurt. They feel betrayed. I feel like this is something that you may have been, you know, on the fence about, but you feel like you've received the truth about it. So I feel like there is some type of, you know, cause and effect type of mindset you have going on with this person. I just got like super drained, like just like a minute ago, like super drained. This person like maybe super draining. Like I'm just looking at this and it's maybe a little bit draining. You may feel like someone's trying to avoid consequences of something, or they're trying to be vindictive, or they're trying to deflect some type of betrayal here. but yet you feel like they're still trying to seduce you into something. And I feel like the problem is here, Taurus, is I feel like you know the truth of the situation, but on top of that, I feel like you're in a space of you're willing to talk, but you want the truth. And I don't really see you getting the truth as much as you want to. And I do see you putting your foot down to something from the past. And I feel like, I don't know why you're having such a hard time letting go of this person. What's the main blockage here? Four of Pentacles. Honestly, you may just see this as someone that's valuable, or they have a lot of money, honestly. Or you may feel like this person brings a lot of value into your life with the Empress. For some of you, you have children with them. I feel like the main blockage is you do authentically want to nurture this, but you feel like this person is just greedy, really. Anything new coming in for Taurus? Because this feels past Taurus, and I wouldn't let someone have you hung up this long. Ace of Cups, so there is something new on the table for you, Taurus. But I feel like you're still trying to manage something that's, look, it's like a lot of you guys need to stop catering or trying to balance out something that's just one-sided, or you're constantly undervalued, or you're constantly being taken advantage of. Maybe your generosity is being taken advantage of. So I feel like there is a new love offer coming in. Could be from a Sagittarius. It doesn't have to be. You may just need to kind of stop catering to whatever this is in the past. What is? Give me a tarot card for advice for this past energy, because I see your frustration here, because again, there is still a desire to talk or be fair. So advice for the past person, we do have the moon. So be a little bit more sacred with your emotions, with your desires. You know, don't try to, you know, if you have to tell someone how to love you all the time and like they don't seem to understand, it's like you may need to kind of put your emotions first here. And also, some of you guys may be missing opportunities trying to nurture something that isn't really what you would like it to be. Okay, the moon card can say, like, you may have an ideal on something, or yes, you have love for someone, but it's still leaving you bored and unsatisfied and feeling rejected, feeling like someone's, you know, being a pity party all the time, or whatever it may be. And this is just saying, like, things aren't what they appear to be. And it's like you may be, there may be a need here to consider your own emotional needs, because this is advice. And as advice for the Queen of Cups, that's saying to consider your own emotional needs and stop putting your emotional needs on the back burner to cater to someone else or to consider someone else. And if you have to talk to your lover like a child, you know, because there's this constant poor me energy or whatever, it's like you may need to kind of move away or distance yourself from that situation, because it's causing you to miss opportunities. And there is something new on the table, but it's going to require you to, you know, restore the balance and get into a better space and, you know, get into a place where you feel worthy of that love, you know. And we do that by developing some type of self-love or putting ourselves first. And I do see you being very assertive. So you do have enough self-love and self-worth of being very assertive and direct and honest. But sometimes when you're so independent that you're naturally used to not needing anybody, we justify ourselves in situations that are not fair. And just because you're someone that's very independent, where you don't need anybody, it doesn't mean you need to put up with a situation that is not giving or reciprocating. Okay? So don't justify that. Don't say, well, I'm not needy. I don't need that. I can make my own money. I can, you know, come on. Like, we all need, it needs to be equal give and take to some extent. Okay? And that may be starting to become taken advantage here with someone. Okay? Give me an oracle for Taurus. We have unlikely. So if you were hoping for some type of reciprocation here from someone, I don't see it happening. We do have perfect timing to say no. Perfect timing, no. I'm gonna give you one more. Remain positive. Positive. So you may need to say no to someone, okay? It may be the perfect timing to end something. Literally, this could be something that you've outgrown, or allow yourself to go through some type of, you know, transition or move on from something. Remain positive, but you know, you need to put yourself first sometimes, okay? I hope this helped you. You could be dealing with a Scorpio. We have Cancer, Gemini, Leo, Taurus, Libra. Could be any sign as far as elements go. I hope this helped you, and all the best.